वेलकम टू वन एंड ऑल, वेलकम टू समग्र शिक्षा अभियान सिद्दिपेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट तेलंगाना। माय नेम इज के सत्य प्रमोद। आई एम वर्किंग एज ए पीजीटी मैथमेटिक्स इन दौलताबाद मंडल सिद्दिपेट डिस्ट्रिक्ट। सो बिफोर एंट्रिंग टू द टॉपिक, आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट यू टू गेस द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक by observing the examples which are going to be shown in the next slide. So name can be different, but at least you know then the topic meaning should be the same. So try to guess the thing. So moving to the numbers which I'm going to give you for observing. So let us observe the first series of numbers which are appearing on the screen is 2, 4, 8, 16 and 32. So 2, 4, 8, 16 and 32 and so on. The second series of numbers are 3, 9, 27, 81, 243 and so on. And third one is 5, 10, 25, 35, 50 and so on. And the fourth one is 4, 16, 64, 256 and 1024 and so on. So what is the common thing that we can observe among these four series of numbers is, so already we know about the arithmetic progression. So when you apply the same knowledge to the here, instead of adding the fixed number to the preceding number to get the succeeding number, here clearly we can see that by multiplying a fixed number we are getting the numbers. Out of these four examples, one is different or one is not in a proper manner. Let us see which one is not in a proper manner and what are those three series which are in a proper manner. So let us try to understand, let us calculate the things properly. So 2 will become 4 by multiplying with 2. So 2 2s are 4. So 2 is multiplied with 2 to get the 4, and 4 is multiplied by 2 to get the 8, and 8 is multiplied by 2 to get the 16, and 16 again is multiplied by 2 to get the 32. So what is happening in the series 1 is the fixed common number which is multiplied each and every time is 2. So it is in a properly arranged numbers. Okay, and let us see the second one. So 3 will become 9 by multiplying with 3. 9 will become 27 again by multiplying with 3, and 27 will become 81 by multiplying by 3, and so on. So again, consistently we are multiplying by 3 each and every preceding term to get the next term. So now coming to the third example, 5 will become 10 if you multiply by 2. 5 will become 10 if you multiply by 2, and 10 if you multiply by 2, you are supposed to get 20, but it is given as 25. Means here the multiplied constant is 2 in the first, between the first and second term, and the second term if you multiply with the same constant which one used in earlier terms, you are supposed to get 20, but it is given as 25. Means it is breaking, rule is broken here. So the third one is an example for not in a proper manner or not in a proper pattern. Okay, the fourth one, 4 is multiplied by 4 so that we will get 16. 4 is multiplied by 4 to get the 16. 16 is multiplied with 4 so that we will get 64, and 64 is multiplied with 4 to get the 256. 256 is multiplied with again 4 to get the 1024. So on the screen, the four examples which are given here, except the third one, the remaining three are following a fixed pattern. That is nothing but if you multiply with a fixed constant number to the preceding one, then only you are getting the next term. So first one, second one and fourth one are in a proper pattern, and third one is not in a proper manner. So instead of adding, we are multiplying here. So when you are adding, you said those things are in arithmetic progression. Now we are saying here we are multiplying a fixed number. So when you are multiplying a fixed number, what we are going to call them as? So we observe that series of numbers with the same common ratio. Ratio means by which we are going to multiply, or with which we are going to multiply. These type of series of numbers are called in geometric progression. Children, observe here, when you multiply to get the next number, then you said they are in geometric progression. In earlier video, when you add a fixed quantity to get the next number, they are said to be in arithmetic progression. So let us welcome to the new topic, geometric progression. So what is geometric progression? What are its properties? Let us see. So progression is our chapter, you know already. So there are two types of progression, you already know. Let us recall that as once again. So based upon the rule, there are two types of progression. One is arithmetic progression and another one is geometric progression. Arithmetic progression we are going to get by adding a fixed quantity each and every time, and geometric progression we are going to get by multiplying a fixed quantity each and every time. Now what is an GP? So GP is nothing but geometric progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by multiplying a fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. So obviously we have to exclude the first term, because by multiplying the first term only we are going to get the second term. So the general form will be like this: AR power 1, here nothing is written, is nothing but power 1, AR power 2, AR power 3, and so on. Here A is nothing but first term as mentioned in the arithmetic progression also, and R is nothing but common ratio. Now the introduction which was given for geometric progression, I think all of you understand. Now let us try to solve some basic problems so that you'll understand and get some doubts, so that you know, by discussing those doubts you might completely you might be able to understand completely the topic. Make a geometric progression in which the common ratio is 3. Nothing but each and every time what we have to do, children, each and every time you have to multiply by 3 to get the next term. Suppose you are starting with 1 should be multiplied with 3, so you will get the second term as 3. Again that 3 should be multiplied by 3 because the common ratio is mentioned as 3, so it will be 9 should be multiplied by 3, then you are supposed to get 27. In the same manner you have to go ahead. So make a geometric progression in which the common ratio is -2. Actually minus is should be written here, so it's a typing error, so treat it as -2. Okay, is -(-2). -2 means you have to be very careful, because negative times of negative is nothing but positive. Minus into minus is plus. That we have to be careful. Discuss with your friends, cross check your answers, discuss with your teacher or communicate with your teacher and cross check your answer. Make a geometric progression in which the common ratio is +2 and the first term is 1/8. Children, this will test your ability to manage the fractions, because 1/8 is a fraction which should be taken as 1/8 should be taken as a first term, and it should be multiplied with each and every time 2. So discuss again this one with your friends. Do the multiplication of fraction and an integer and try to simplify and get the answer. See children, once you open up and discuss with your friends and teachers, then only you will get the doubts, and doubts are clarified, then only you will be clear with the topic. Now make a geometric progression in which the common ratio is 1/5 and first term is 625, which is similar. You can refer to the textbooks, examples are given here, given there, and by referring those examples you can even do this kind of problems. Now this is a tricky question and conceptual question. Can a geometric progression has its first term as 0? Is it possible to, or is it possible to take 0 as a first term of a geometric progression? Yes or no? Justify your answer. So give the reason. Can you take? Why you cannot take? Why you can't take? So give the reason, justify answer. So this is a small introduction video. Definitely the upcoming videos will be more elaborated and more clear. So this video, I hope all of you understand. And any doubts and queries, discuss with your friends, discuss with your teacher, and comment it, and definitely we try to solve it out. Thank you one and all for watching this video. Thank you.